This is Stacy, your hostess here at the Club Cabana. And I hope everyone is doing absolutely wonderful out there. And what I'd like for you to do now is sit back, enjoy your cold beverage, and welcome to the stage, the one and only, Mr. Dr. Cranky.
Lab-RAT-ory with another episode of the Cranky Show, and we are continuing to discuss the basics of painting and some other important information. Let me just remove all the tiny little parts from my coffee filter where I normally rinse my parts and then let them dry. A couple of things before we get going here. This got a lot of great responses from everybody, and I wanted to say that to make it complete, I recommend basically drill bits like this, right? And it would all still fit in there. This one is good on the hand versus this other one, this double-headed one, where it just gets to be a little rough. But you could also get thumb screw type of drill bits that come already like that, or different, you know, I have a whole bunch of them. I don't use them all. And then, of course, to complete your travel kit, Tamiya Extra Thin Cement, I have a whole bunch of that stuff. Now, we have here all the engine parts, right, based on the wonderful instructions, right? Let me just turn to that page. Here we go. So here's where some of the preliminary stuff begins, right? For me, this, of course, is a personal approach. What works for me might not necessarily work for you, but I'm just covering it just in case it does. So, you know, we removed all the parts for the engine, right, and cleaned them up really well, sanded them, removed whatever imperfections. The little oil pan here, or transmission pan, has a little dent, which we're not going to worry about that much because we might be able to do something, so we're not sweating it. Also, a few other places here. Again, you can cover it up with putty, right, and or crazy glue mixed in with baking powder or whatever you use. But we're not going to sweat it yet. Now, one thing I wanted to bring up right away is that, you know, in part, this is a collaboration that I'm doing with Freddie Pena over at H-Town Models. And he already started his, right? And his is going to be silver with some other things. So I'm thinking silver and gold. So I'm thinking right now, preliminarily, I am going to go with gold, and we're going to try it out on the engine. So looking at the instructions, a lot of this is painted orange, right? So that's not going to work for me. You paint, you know, your engine, and you paint your model whatever way. You don't have to really follow the instructions. So we're going to go with gold and some other accents that are going to make the engine really stand out. We're not going to detail the heck out of the engine, but we're also not going stock. So that's, you know, some of these early questions get answered right away once you decide. So, you know, the other thing is that I wanted to bring up, the engine has a lot of parts that you can go ahead and glue already because they're all basically orange, right? But I'm going to reserve a couple to paint some other color just for a little variety, right? We don't know what we're going to do with the carbs yet. We're going to put an aftermarket distributor on there. So we need to go back in and drill some holes. So this is where we're at right now. And so we'll continue to work on it and get it ready for primer and then get it ready for paint. We will build the engine and then put it aside and move on to the chassis, etc., etc. So you'll get the process. You're also welcome to build along if you want to partake, you know, get a kit and start working on the engine, and we'll have some fun. All right, my friends, stay tuned in for the next episode coming right up.